Hey everyone, how's it going? Welcome back to another Walking Dead video. So I wanted to focus on a couple of things here. There's actually some Daryl Dixon promotion that I do want to talk about, but I also want to focus on something that I saw from AMC regarding, I guess, all the striking happening and stuff with the actors and how that could actually affect The Walking Dead and whatnot. And yeah, so I want to get into that. So before we go any further, obviously make sure to be a subscriber if you want to get all my Walking Dead content like this. I apologize for like the lack of content for the last week. For those that kind of follow me on my Patreon and all that, you guys probably would have saw that I did mention that I was going camping, and we did go camping. There was a bunch of stuff happening, and in the last couple of days, honestly, I just haven't really been feeling the best, but I'm feeling really good now, so that's obviously why I posted the video today, and it's just sort of coming back down from, you know, all of that. Like, it does take a while to sort of adjust from just, you know, and all of that, but I'm back now, and honestly, I'm really excited because the Daryl Dixon show is premiering in like a month and 5 days, I guess, as of, I guess, me recording this video. And I really can't wait. They're really promoting this show a lot right now. There's a lot more new footage. I'm not going to get into everything here in this video. I'll save that for my next video coming out tomorrow. But yeah, which I guess I did mention the Patreon. So if you do want to have vlogs from me and see more, you know, personal stuff from me and all that, my Patreon link is in the description of this video. I do post vlogs there every single Sunday, and a lot of it is sort of like a weight loss journey, but also just kind of I guess a life journey in a sense of, like, I don't know, just kind of picking up the pieces of just where, you know, I mean, I'm sure some of you guys already know what happened to me earlier this year and whatnot. So it's just sort of, you know, getting back into feeling like myself again. And if not, just even better, because there's a lot of stuff. Anyways, if you're interested, the link's in the description, but let's actually get into this here. So I guess the first thing I do want to get into, because the other thing is kind of a longer discussion, and that is that The Walking Dead has been really promoting a lot of stuff with Daryl Dixon, and there's quite a bit of stuff. And again, I'm not going to be able to get into a lot of stuff. There's some stuff with the new villain Codron. He actually is a villain that I'm really excited about, because I think as a character, he's going to be able to be very menacing towards Daryl and actually feel like a very threatening, scary villain, right? Because it's been quite a while on all the shows since we've had a character feel like that. No one at the Commonwealth felt scary and just threatening like that. You know, even in Dead City, there wasn't really, I mean, there was the Walker King, I guess that was one thing, right? But like, there's been no character that has really felt like that. And Codron kind of feels like that. Codron really feels, honestly, like Simon. I was never scared of Simon. Like, I was never terrified of Simon. Simon was just kind of a cool character, you know, like, obviously we knew he was a villain and he did bad things, but he was just kind of a cool villain. But Codron, he's a little terrifying. You know, he's, again, there's still so much about these characters that we need to learn, but like, it's one of those things where I think he could be a really, really fantastic villain. I honestly think he could actually be a really phenomenal villain and maybe even outshine some of the other cast just because of just some of the interviews and stuff that I've been seeing anyways. Like, he really looks like a phenomenal villain. But yeah, and in terms of what they've been promoting, they've been doing some like character portrait like stuff. It's not necessarily character portraits. I noticed they haven't really done character portraits in a while, but what they will do is this sort of like, I don't know, like character portrait video type thing. Like, we have this stuff here of Daryl, and then Codron's obviously here. And it's a lot of, I mean, obviously this is like promotional stuff, right? Like, the actors came here to actually shoot some promotional stuff here. And this feels a lot like what character portraits used to look like, but, you know, and just in terms of a video format. And it looks absolutely incredible. Honestly, I think that this show is going to be probably, it could be the best show of the three. And I'm not trying to, like, obviously, like, say that the Rick and Michonne show is going to be, like, not as good as the Daryl Dixon show, because we haven't seen any footage really yet. We haven't seen a trailer or anything like that. But there's just something about the Daryl Dixon show and it being in France and the tone of the show and all of that that makes it so unique, so fascinating, that I think some people are overlooking. And I think once we watch the first just 2-3 episodes, we're going to realize why they went to France, why they're going with this tone overall. And you know, we'll just have to wait and see. Because the thing about the Rick and Michonne show, I'm not trying to say anything bad about the show at all. I'm just saying, like, this show is going to feel a lot like The Walking Dead, right? So if you love The Walking Dead and just, you know, just what the story's been for however many years, it's probably going to feel a lot like that, which isn't a bad thing. It's just that there's nothing new and exciting about it, right? Besides, obviously, Rick and Michonne returning. That's going to be a lot of fun. That part there, along with some of the other characters, it's going to be really fantastic. And again, I'm saying this all before seeing the trailer. I could watch the trailer and then completely change my mind, but there's just something about the Daryl show. And I don't know, again, I talked about it after Comic-Con. Once I watched the trailer for the Daryl Dixon show, I was really blown away by it. I was not expecting this kind of tone for the show, and the show just looks Incredible. So yeah, I'm very excited. We got about, what is that, 26 days? No, 26 plus 10. So 36 days. I guess we'll probably watch on the 7th on AMC Plus. So that's 33 days away. So we're very close to the premiere here, right? So any new footage, anything like that that we do get, I will be breaking all of it down. But I also wanted to talk about one thing that I saw in an article here from comicbook.com. I'll leave a link down below to the article. But obviously with the strike and stuff happening right now, people were wondering, like, is this going to affect The Walking Dead, or how could it affect The Walking Dead? And the AMC CEO says that the strike isn't going to affect programming really until well into 2024. And I did talk about this before. I did mention, like, they filmed all of Daryl Dixon already. They were filming season two for that show. Dead City, I think, was about to start season two for filming. And then the Rick and Michonne show is already done. That show's coming out early 2024, it seems like. And also, they have Fear the Walking Dead's last six episodes airing at the end of October, right? So in terms of how it's going to affect Walking Dead content specifically, it's not necessarily going to, because them even filming Dead City right now and Daryl Dixon, like season two for both shows, was very early. Like, I feel like they could film that early next year and still have those shows come out for whatever time next year, right? Like, say they start filming in like early 2024, say it's January or even March, like say they both shows start filming in March of next year. It would affect the summer a little bit, I guess, in terms of a release. But then again, like a couple of years ago, we never had any Walking Dead content in the summers, right? Like Fear would air here and there, but it was always like this very long break until The Walking Dead, you know, appeared in October. It could be something like that as well. We just sort of, we watch the Rick and Michonne show, it ends maybe early April or something like that. We have a break until October, and then like that's where we get Daryl Dixon season two or Dead City season two, depending on what they want to air then. If you read the quote here from comicbook.com, it says, between Daryl Dixon season one, Fear the Walking Dead season 8B, and The Ones Who Live season one, all consisting of six episodes, AMC has banked a total 18 new Walking Dead universe episodes to air through the remainder of 2023 and into 2024. So when I see that, honestly, that just like, again, it kind of lines up with what I've been saying. Like, I think The Walking Dead's, I don't think we're really going to see that much of an effect. You know, if the strike is still happening early into next year, I think it's still fine in terms of that. Now, in terms of other content, obviously shows and stuff that they usually would air, again, like the quote here of the article is that, or not the quote, but the headline, you know, of the article here says that AMC CEO says strikes won't impact programming until well into 2024. So I only think we're really going to see the effects of it in terms of that, like next summer. And that's, again, I think they still have some time here. I think that there's some studios that don't obviously have the time. Like some studios probably are really relying on like filming right now kind of thing, right? But I think them, you know, filming a lot of the stuff for The Walking Dead much earlier and much sooner and just banking all of these episodes and all that, it kind of works for them, right? So we're going to have a lot of Walking Dead stuff for quite a while here. There was also some other things too that I wanted to talk about in terms of just the state of AMC and just kind of a lot of that here. So I do see part of the article here says that the advertising revenues or something decreased 17% to $167 million due to anticipated linear ratings declines, softness in the ad market, and fewer original programming episodes within the quarter that ended on June 30th. So, I mean, if you're looking at, you know, The Walking Dead and in terms of just the release for that, like there was no Walking Dead content that aired for the first half of this year. Right. And normally we would get a lot of Walking Dead content. We would get quite a bit of Walking Dead content, I would say, within the first half of the year, because we would usually get eight episodes from February to whatever. And then sometimes even Fear the Walking Dead right after in April. Right. Or even in June. So it makes sense that they sort of saw some, you know, revenues dropping here. And they also did talk about Dead City and the series premiere being the number one season premiere in the history of AMC Plus. So to me, that's really cool. Apparently, the first episode attracted like 2 million viewers or something like that. There's quite a bit of stuff. Like, honestly, when I'm looking at it, I really do think that like AMC is navigating this entire world here of streaming services and all of that pretty well. I was actually reading an article a couple of days ago, and I was going to do a video on it, but I'll kind of get my thoughts on it here. I believe it was by Forbes, but they were talking about AMC being bought by like Netflix or something like that. And if that were to go down, then Netflix would own everything that AMC kind of has, right? Like The Walking Dead and all of that. So Netflix could make Walking Dead shows. And so obviously you look at the budget of Stranger Things and all of that. They could do that, obviously, for the Walking Dead universe. They could probably do quite a bit of stuff with the Walking Dead universe. That is something, I guess, that could kind of work, obviously. But I do think overall AMC is kind of handling it fine. You know, I don't understand the finance stuff, like, really. Judging by what other people are saying, they're just kind of always, you know, breaking even, or they're just kind of, like, barely getting by kind of thing. But it kind of feels like some stuff has changed, because, again, that article I read was from, like, many, many months ago. It might have been, like, late last year. So that wasn't really taking into account stuff that happened this year, right? And the success of Dead City and all of that. So I do think overall, you know, The Walking Dead is in a very good place. I think that it's interesting in terms of just the streaming world right now, because the streaming world is just so, like, you have Disney Plus, you have Netflix and all of that, and that's pretty much it. And then anything else, like Paramount Plus, I mean, there's obviously AMC Plus, and there's, like, Shudder and all of that. Like, there's a lot of those streaming services that are just never going to be able to match that. But I will say AMC Plus is actually doing a pretty good job, because the shows that are coming out on that are actually really entertaining. I've been watching Dark Winds lately, and it's such a good show. They have Fear the Walking Dead on there now, which is, like, that's amazing. And they're eventually going to have all 11 seasons of The Walking Dead on AMC Plus. So if you want to watch The Walking Dead at all, you're going to have to get AMC Plus. And that is such a big thing there, because the one thing that I will say too about The Walking Dead, and people always say, well, the ratings are dropping, this and that. I mean, first of all, I don't think the ratings have dropped in a very long time. I really think that they've just sort of been staying there. If anything, they've sort of increased in the last couple of months because of Dead City. But The Walking Dead, whenever there's new seasons or new episodes, not even new episodes, just in general, it feels like that show is always in the top 10 on Netflix. Like, it's just always there. So there's a lot of interest. When that show has new episodes and new season, lots of people watch immediately, right? So, you know, that could also be something for Netflix as well. You know, like, they know that show is pretty big on their platform. Like, why not make more seasons? Like, what if we bought The Walking Dead or something like that? Like, you never know where that can go, right? But overall, I think that, again, I think AMC is doing a really great job with Walking Dead content in general. It seems like right now they have a lot of faith in The Walking Dead. And I'm really excited to see just where the shows go over the next couple of years. And, you know, obviously we're probably going to get a season 2, season 3, or we are getting season 2, but a season 3, season 4, you know, we'll see where they go at some point. But The Walking Dead, there's a lot there. There's a lot of story that you can tell. And I think Dead City proved that. And now we have Daryl Dixon. I'm very excited for this show. So I'm going to leave it here. Post all your thoughts down below. Hope you guys all enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys in the next one.